was speaking too early. Your lack of buddies is a little concerning. You heard the rumors, now I'm hearing confirming. I made a friend in my 30s.
Welcome to Jam Mechanics, Season 2, Episode 10, the season finale. Welcome to the Jam Cabin. The Jam Cabin is smaller than usual because we are in adjoining rooms.
We've done a live episode before. Hi, I'm Bug from Bug Hunter.
I'm Narcissist Cookbook, Matt.
Yes, you are. We've done a live episode before. We're in the same room. Now we're in the same house, but we decided we don't like each other anymore. We've been in the van together for about two and a half weeks, and we're not friends anymore. So
we're neither friends nor lovers. We're a secret third thing, which is podcast hosts. Yeah, I'm recording on my laptop. It's the kind of thing that it would, if you were looking up this laptop at a store, it would say great for browsing the internet and sending emails. So it's that we're in that sort of situation.
It's not been podcast approved. Speaking of podcasts, this is a podcast. This is a podcast called Jam Mechanics. We are a song challenge podcast. Here's what is going to happen. If you've never listened to us before, Matt and I are both professional songwriters. We have bands. Mine is called Bug Hunter. Matt's is called The Narcissist Cookbook. Currently on tour together. That's why we're recording on the road. But what we do is we're going to get a song challenge, and we are going to go away for 3 hours, write some kind of demo, kind of inspired by that song challenge, and then we're going to come back and show it to each other and just rip each other to shreds.
Exactly. It's not pretty. We are also currently rated, we are ranked number zero.
We're number zero.
What happened there again?
I got a notification at 6 a.m. from Spotify podcast app that was like, congratulations, you've made the music charts. And I opened it up and it said, here's a big banner to share with your fans, your big achievement. And it says, you are ranked number zero on the music podcast charts. And my favorite comment was somebody on Instagram that said, we're number none. We're number none. Which is such a good rallying cry. Well, before we get down to all that, Matt, do you want to get to know each other?
Yeah. I have an icebreaker for you, and okay. I want to pull back the curtain and say, I said that sentence with nothing prepared, hoping that I would reach the end of it with something prepared.
I got a question for you.
Get it in my ears.
If your co-host was locked in a deadly combat with an evil doppelganger and you had a gun, what question would you ask to know which one was the real one and which one would you take out? I have an answer for you.
Okay, but doesn't have access to your memories, I'm assuming, because if it does, then
yeah, well then it's game over.
Yeah, just kill both of you to be safe.
Okay, to be safe.
I gotta be safe. So I gotta be safe from the doppelganger. I would, man, my creative brain is really struggling. Okay, okay. Give me a second. I'm getting into it. Okay. I'm in an alley.
Okay.
I walk down the alley and there was a door to my left. And I open the door and I walk down. There are blinking lights. There are rusted metal handholds going down the stairs. And then at the bottom is a single light dangling from the ceiling, an unshielded light bulb. And there is two tied up bugs in the middle of the room. And okay, this is my happy place. This is my comfort place. I pull the hood off of both of you at the same time, and I take the socks out of your mouth, and I'm like, okay, we're gonna resolve this. I'm gonna ask you one question. If you can get that question right, or whatever,
or whatever I feel like,
yeah. Okay, because my first thought was actually, in a board game, what is important? Is it important to have a good time or is it important to win? And then I was like, you know what? Both of you are going to have the same answer to that. Like, okay, listen, you know what? This hasn't resolved the situation. I'm just going to have to kill you both. I'm so sorry for my safety.
It's sad to know that there is no way to discern myself from an evil doppelganger of myself.
Well, this is the thing, right? Because I've always had a difficulty with these, because if you both have the same brain, but one of you's evil, there's nothing I can ask to tell the difference between the two of you. Again, kill both of you and hope that there isn't a third doppelganger out there, because that would be the true doppelganger move.
The troppelganger.
Ah, fuck. God, that's really good. Bug, you walk into a room with 5,000 me's. One of them is the real me. And you have one question.
My question would be, did Courtney do it?
Courtney didn't do it.
Yeah, there you go. I shoot everybody else. Evil Matt writes Courtney unironically. Evil Bug writes Dear McCracken and doesn't care how it ends up.
Evil Bug writes Two Bed, Two Bath, and a Ghost and has a very specific idea of how it ends. I just also want to say for the people at home, for reasons we can't figure out, Bug's voice is pitched up by about like 4 semitones. You're not going to be able to hear it. Maybe we can imitate it for a second in this edit. I don't know. But it's really... It's a very...
I can't hear it. I think you're making it up.
No, it sounds like this. It's like, hello, my name is Bug Cunner. You know, it's really... It's
the troppelganger.
Shit! Pew, pew, pew! Okay, so... We're at the end of our second season. We got 2 more episodes to go. This episode that we're currently in, and the retrospective, which is going to be after this. But before that, we got to write one more song. And by one more song, I mean 2 more songs. Yeah. One from you, one from me. And what better way to end the second season than where we began? So we're going to bring back the guest from season 2, episode 1, by popular demand, a Deep Blue Ink. Say hello, Deep Blue Ink.
Hello, I'm popular demand.
Deep Blue Ink, we have an icebreaker, because I'm assuming a lot has changed for you. It's been it's been how many weeks? It must have been like...
Oh, I didn't study for this.
It's been months since we've been able to chat. Yeah. Matt, do you have an icebreaker? Because I have one.
If you were walking into a room and there was a single unshielded light bulb hanging from the ceiling, and there were 2 chairs next to the light bulb, and there were hooded figures in the chairs, and you pull the hood off one of them and it's Bug, and then you pull off the hood off the other one and it's Bug again, and you're like, one of these is an evil doppelganger, and I get one question.
The old classic 2 hooded robes in an empty room with a light bulb question.
Yeah, exactly. It's the classic question.
The light bulb's important.
What would I ask Bug to... Wait, is it one always lies? Is it one is just evil.
One is just evil. One is me, but one is evil.
I'm not going to lie. I feel like I could tell by how uncomfortable you were, like, stood in a dark room under a hood. No. I think the real you would be a little bit, like, upset by the situation.
Whereas Evil Bug would just be like, yeah, I'm vibing. This is my
environment. I'm fucking into this.
Yeah, break the light bulb.
Yeah, Evil Bug just hands you a baseball bat.
Like, there would be a vibe.
Or it's just physical altercation. I don't know, maybe I just fight you, and whichever one I feel like I'd beat is the real Bug.
Also, I do need to remind you that it is a reasonable choice to just kill both of them to keep yourself safe and to protect humanity from the
Well, that's the thing. I don't even have any, like... You've not even told me, like, what's going to happen. At this point, I'm just walking into a room and fighting 2 bugs. This is great.
You don't need to fight them. You have, like...
this is a great day.
It's too late.
You've got to undo it.
I've already killed one of them. The other one's bloody to an inch of his life.
Yeah, no one said to kill one of them. You just found us and just started doing that.
I didn't even see the second bug. I just saw one bug and just started throwing hands.
Amazing. Well, so we have Deep Blue Ink here. What Deep Blue Ink is going to do is... They're going to come in here with 2 songwriting prompts. We have them bring 2 because we want to fight. Obviously, we're primed to fight. We're ready to fight. Our doppelgangers are ready to fight. Our troppelgangers are ready to fight. We have Deep Blue Ink come in here with 2 prompts so that we can discuss and come together. It's not Matt chooses one, I choose the other. We both choose one, and we bounce off of that single prompt. So, with that being said, Deep Blue Ink, do you have your first prompt for us?
I do have your first prompt for us. So I obviously was in the first episode, and I've been thinking about being invited back and kind of what that means for this as a prompt, you know, how it's going to have to differ from the first 2 that I gave you. So my first prompt is, in quote marks, a second chance you shouldn't have been given.
Oh, a second chance you should not have been given. In quote marks.
Certainly okay. On the post-it note that I wrote on the wall to remind me what my prompts were, yeah.
All right, let's internalize that, and then we're ready for prompt number two.
For all of the eighth episode so far this season of Jam Mechanics, I have, after every single episode, gone back to both the songs and listened to each of them on repeat until mm-hmm. I've drained them of all the serotonin I possibly can.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
So, I want a song that is meant to be played on loop.
Oh.
A song that is meant to be played on loop.
And frankly, both of you, if that prompt is essentially me saying, I want you to write a song that's good, then I will come up with a third prompt.
Oh, these are good prompts.
Matt, what's your gut?
I like both of those. Song meant to be played on a loop, to me, feels like an arrangement challenge. Like I would try and come up with a song that you could, that would just sort of play indefinitely and would feel mm-hmm. like it would feel... Yeah, I don't know, but it also feels less interesting to me. I think A Second Chance You Shouldn't Have Been Given gives me, that's more of a springboard for me.
I'm with you. I feel like the loop is more of a structure challenge, whereas A Second Chance You Shouldn't Have Been Given, I think I really like that a lot. I think you would come back and just said A Second Chance. I'm like, that's a good prompt, but A Second Chance You Shouldn't Have Been Given is so tantalizing. There's something there.
Okay. Fantastic.
We good to do that?
Yeah.
We have given Deep Blue Ink a second chance that they definitely deserved, because that is a great prompt.
Wrong. Very good job. I'm going to say as many swear words as I can in the next 2 minutes.
but Deep Blue Ink, it is lovely to see you. Lovely to hear from you. How would I know if I went into the dark room down the damp stairs and took the hood light bulb and the light bulb's flickering and I took the hood off of one and it was a Deep Blue Ink and I took the hood off the other one, it was Deep Blue Ink. How would I know?
Matt, there could not possibly be a second more evil Deep Blue Ink. Sorry. This is null and void.
Yeah, this already happened and somebody got it wrong.
this is shoot to kill on sight. amazing. Well, Deep Blue Ink, what are you working on these days? What do you want people to know about that you've got either in the pipeline or coming out right about now being end of September?
End of September? Yeah, well, I'm getting married end of October, which is exciting. And I'm also, and I'll start talking about this end of September. I've been working on something for the last year. It's going to be over a year by the time it comes out. I'm going to release some details about it in December, and you will see it on your screens, big screen, no, on YouTube in January. Keep an eye out for that.
If only Very we exciting. Knew anything about that.
If only you two knew anything about it and guessed it in it.
fantastic. Okay, well, Bug, we got to go off and we gotta retreat through time and space, and we're going to come back with a song based on A Second Chance You Shouldn't Have Been Given. Slam!
That's a good ending, Matt.
Yeah, that's the end of that section. I made a friend in my 30s.
And we are back in the most literal sense of the word. Not only are we back from the break, we are back from our tour. We literally just rolled up to the Jamma Cabin from a 30-day U.S. tour.
This tour was incredible. What a time this has been.
It's been
but
so
on
fun.
Top of that, we also have been struggling to record this Jamma Mechanics.
But we're doing it. We're doing it in the literally last possible second because Matt is flying. Matt is on an airplane in 2 hours, but we are getting this episode done. So how was your experience? I know we basically the way that this one worked, we recorded the first half in Nashville, we wrote the songs in Atlanta, and now we're back in Richmond recording the second half. How was your time kind of writing the song?
Writing it, great. Mm-hmm. Like I think it is a good piece of work.
Give it a minute.
Why?
An ice cream truck.
Fucking ice cream truck.
The natural enemy.
Yeah.
Of the Jam Mechanics.
I keep thinking we're top of the food chain and then the ice cream truck turns up and the
I called the all the lawn care companies in the county today and I said, "Hey, We only have like a hot second to record this episode. No lawnmowers. And then, of course, wouldn't you know it, the most obnoxious ice cream lady in the entire world drives by. She has this, it's the normal kind of ring-a-ling thing that all ice cream trucks have, but this one, every about 20 seconds, just says, "Hello." I'm gonna try. I'm sure this isn't gonna be on the podcast, but I'm gonna try and get this hello on my microphone. You hear that?
No, but I bet your microphone did.
Okay, I definitely got it.
Go in the podcast now. So she's still out there, still.
Yeah, I don't think she's still hunting. I don't think anyone's buying, but.
There's an ice cream truck out there. I could go and get it.
We could go get ice cream.
Cut, and we were just holding ice creams. is she still out there?
I think she has moved on to...
Okay, cool.
Yeah, so I think we're probably good to keep going.
So my song, I had a great time writing it. Everything else I'd like to say after we listen to the recording.
Okay, so I have a song here called Orchids.
Yep. I cannot send you the lyrics because my laptop is specifically set. Oh, no, maybe I probably can send you the lyrics. Give me a second. Why did I buy this piece of shit? An update is required to install. I need to install an update.
I'm not even going to read them. I'll just listen to the song.
Okay, cool.
All right.
Right. Are you ready for Orchids?
I'm ready for Orchids. So I am going to hit play on this song in 3, 2, 1.
From the dark garden to the living room windows, we are dancing, you are laughing, reveling in the novelty of my abandon. This is new, you think. I see your frown encroaches on your smile. A very old, you think, but the worry's just a weed. You are spun around the room, I am static in the flower bed. You are crying, laughing now, and I am trying not to trample on your orchids. I pull my jacket closer, you are snuggled on the couch with me, dozing, visibly relieved, and I'm relieved as well. In my way, I try to catch my eye, but there's just no getting through to me. This is good, I think, hiding from the lights of passing cars. If I can't live it, well, I guess I'll watch it from afar. You are warm, you are happy, you are safe inside with me. I am trying not to trample on your orchids. Sleep, I watch me blinking in the television light. Maybe get a little taller, a little younger around the eyes. This is new, I think, or something very, very old. But the worry's just a weed, and I retreat into the cold. This is good, I think, in a way, a second start. If I can't live it, well, I guess I'll watch it from afar. You are warm, you are happy, you are safe, at least I hope. But I am trying, I am trying, I am trying not to trample on the orchids. Not to trample on the orchids.
Yeah, so...
yo.
Okay.
Man, so I would actually love... I would love to have the lyrics to this because, like, I was getting obviously like vibes, and there's a lot of distortion there. I think I picked up kind of what's going on here.
You know, I think I can send the lyrics from my phone.
Okay.
So yeah, I am happy with. I really like the piece. Yeah. We had literally 30 minutes in a stranger's house to me. Stranger to me's house.
Yeah. My aunt and uncle.
Yeah, yeah.
We broke into a stranger's house to record these songs. It was the only way to do it, but we were that committed.
I was doing it in one of their spare rooms. And I was just like, I have this idea of it being this like really, really noisy thing. And I think I didn't have I didn't have it down. I don't think this is the way it should be performed. But now there's this little snapshot of this idea I had for how it was going to be performed.
This is cool. I was like, you know, trying to kind of wrap my head around what's happening, because there's so much noise and like distortion and stuff. Let me just kind of shoot out kind of what I thought the song was about I was kind of like listening to it. So it seemed like it was kind of like this like. Not having this life that you want, and like looking at the life that you want through a window, right? Because there's things about here about obviously watch us from the dark garden through the living room windows, dancing, laughing, and then, but obviously then there's you saying I'm just trying not to trample on the orchids, which kind of gives me like this feeling of like I want to watch this, but I don't want to either ruin it. If the orchids is kind of representing kind of like this relationship thing that's happening, or not wanting to be caught, or leaving a sign that you were there, or, you know, because like you're in the garden, you don't want to accidentally like leave a sign that you were outside the window watching, which was just like, yeah, man, I got goosebumps kind of listening to this.
Do you want me to tell you, because like this in my head, this is not abstract. There is like a specific thing that is happening.
Yeah. Oh yeah, I'd love to hear it.
Okay, so I chose orchids because orchids are famous for evolving to mimic other kinds of flowers and other kinds of animals. So you get like orchids that will mimic bees and butterflies and things like that. So that's the story that is happening here is that somebody has been like living this very sad life where they haven't had a lot of like fun. They've been sort of trapped in their own head, and they come back one night to find that there is a copy of them in their house. And so they're outside in the rain watching their partner interact with this copy of them. And as it says here, that their partner is like reveling in the novelty of my abandon. It's just like, oh, there's this mimic of me in there that is having fun and is making you laugh.
I'm getting goosebumps. Like this is like, ooh, it's like making the hairs on the back of my neck stand up.
Yeah,
in like a good way. And like you're like, oh, it's like a horror story, but like. Yeah. Like this song from the perspective of like the partner is like a horror story. It's like, it's terrifying.
So the partner, like in the first verse, the partner is like, this is new. Like, why are you behaving like this? But eventually it's just like, I'm not going to ask questions because like, this is the person that I have missed that has been away for so long. And the person in the person who has been mimicked is like, you know what? Maybe this is as close as I'm ever going to get to like a second chance at like a do-over of this relationship.
Yeah.
And then it ends with partners asleep and the person is watching the mimic and you can like the mimic is getting a little bit taller, a little bit more attractive. And the person's just like, yeah, fine. Okay.
Yeah.
It's a sad story. And I sort of imagine that this is, you know, like I have an idea in my head of what kind of creature this is, but that's more abstract. So that's literally what's happening.
I know that everybody listening to the podcast knows this because you just listened to the first half, but it has been about 2 weeks since we recorded it. The prompt was a second chance.
That you don't deserve.
That you don't deserve, right.
Whether you think this person didn't deserve a second chance or not is another matter.
But, very, very cool that you also kind of incorporated the doppelganger bit into this. I think that's really neat.
And the guitar part is just me like tuning down the E string. Because originally we were in OKC and we were getting ready and I wasn't even halfway through. I was precisely 1/6 of the way through changing my strings. Yeah. And the only string on my guitar was an E string. And I had this idea to just be like, down. No, and then tune down the E string and be like, durr.
So you're making a song that's impossible to play live.
Oh, no, it's very possible to play live. I played it live in your aunt and uncle's living spare room. I think my read on this is that I love chaos, and I think that chaos works best when it has some order mixed in to ground it, and I think this is just too chaotic.
Matt, the V2 of this is going to bang for sure. I think getting the lyrics like really like to cut through, like I think you're right. I think the chaos is awesome, and but it needs to like to kind of make sure that people are like understanding the words, because I'm reading the words. The words are awesome. This is like a very cool story. Yeah, of all the songs of season 2. Now that we're on episode 10, I can say this is probably the one that I want to see you like come back to this and, yeah. and maybe not record it in my aunt and uncle's guest room.
I was just thinking because, you know, your aunt and uncle welcomed us in and they were so lovely. And then they're just like, oh, they're going to go away and they're going to record. And yeah. then I'm just in their spare room being like,
well, I know that they were getting the full stereo experience because while you were doing this in the guest room, I was in the upstairs like attic space recording a little song of my own. The prompt was a second chance that you don't deserve. And so I came up with a song called The Lighthouse. I guess I don't want to give too much away about what it's about. I'm hoping that's evident, but it is about a second chance.
That you don't deserve.
That, well, you know, yeah, probably.
Okay. So
I'm going to send you the lyrics.
Okay, we're going to listen to The Lighthouse, demo 1.mp3 in 3, 2, 1, go.
On the tip of the island, they left him to linger in a lighthouse that clung to the cliff by its fingers. No comfort or company close to this coast, where he dwelt like a gargoyle guarding his post. They caught me red-handed, prepared my last meal, then gave me an out. I took the deal. Stick to my station, keep my patrol. My only condition, don't hurt a soul. 100 years past me, with no chance to slip. Then on the darkened horizon, I spotted a ship. On the tip of the island, they left him to linger in a lighthouse that clung to the cliff by its finger. With the darkness consuming, I lit up their path. There's only one route through all the rocks and the cracks. I carved out a chance through the maze and the sea, leading the ship up to rest on the beach. The pilgrims abandoned their ship until dawn, but the tide never sleeps. When they woke, it was gone. On the tip of the island, they left him to linger in a lighthouse that clung to the cliff by its finger. Without a ship to sail, the sailors advanced to the valley below, where they set up their camps. The timber was scarce here, which begged them to ask, do we use them for shelter or use them for rafts? I watched from the ridge, an unreachable witness, a fly on the wall with a spider's ambitions. Didn't surprise me at all that the first thing they did was divide into camps, their first building a prison. Dream of a rescue, bless their hearts. I've watched them build and tear apart. Must now be years since they've arrived. Why must the heartless all survive? Their children only know this place. They know I'm here, but not my face. I pray they never seek me out. Oh God, the stories I could tell. They're not to blame, I wish them well. Oh God, the stories I could tell. Years on the island have settled the score. The village below me is violent no more. Then out of the sunset appears a new ship. My heart begins beating, I have to act quick. With only one hope to correct for the night, I left to my senses and smashed out the light. By the light of the morning, there wasn't a sign of the wreckage that washed away deep in the night. I swore to my captors I'd harm no one else, but not doing harm doesn't mean that I'll help. Cause I've kissed the devil and can't be coerced. Of all God's creations, this is the worst. On the tip of the island, they left me to linger in a lighthouse that clung to the cliff by its finger. With the lighthouse abandoned, I start to descend.
You can find me among all the souls I've condemned.
Nice.
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 When we were leaving the show last night, I mm-hmm. think you said there is a line in this mm-hmm. that you are gonna like, or that I really like, or something. Yeah. And is it on the tip of the island they left me to linger in a lighthouse that clung to the cliff by its fingers? Because if it's not, it should be.
I'm really happy with that line. Yeah, no, I wasn't thinking of that one, but that is a pretty good one that I like a lot.
It's really, really good. In the way that I explained the story of mine, and because I have no critical reading skills at all, what in your head is the story of this song?
This is, I don't know if I should give this away, this is a direct sequel to The Hook.
I thought it might be.
Yeah.
I thought it might be.
It is a direct sequel to The Hook, which ended on a cliffhanger.
Yeah. Got 'em.
Friggin' got 'em. Waited a whole season to set that one up.
Is it in the same key?
It is not in the same key, but it uses a lot of the same chords.
Yeah.
It's vibes, yeah.
Okay, very, very cool. Okay, yeah. Cool. So yeah, go on. Tell us, and by us I mean me, because
yeah.
everyone else already understands this. Tell me what happens in this story.
The angel from The Hook. That song kind of ends in a bit of a who's going to be the one taking the fall for this? You know, is the devil going to get caught? Is the angel going to kind of get his comeuppance? And I think I thought a more interesting way to take it was that he does get kind of exiled. So it starts with, they caught me red-handed, prepared my last meal, then gave me an out. I took the deal, and yeah. he's been kind of taken to guard this lighthouse that stands on the cliff of this island that is uninhabited. The only thing that he has to do is just to not hurt anybody. He just has to stay at this lighthouse and not hurt anybody. And then he finds a ship comes along, and he kind of guides them on, and they get shipwrecked, and kind of watches their society kind of grow from kind of infighting about what to do. And he kind of stands as this kind of watcher along the cliff that doesn't interact with the people there at all. Going through like, okay, yeah, they're starting to have kids, but I've seen like kind of what their fathers did to kind of get things in order. At the end, there's this chance for rescue. Another ship is coming, and instead of guiding them in, he smashes the light out and causes them to wreck and wash away, leaving kind of these the inhabitants of the island to kind of be kind of forsaken there forever.
I also notice, and this is, of all of those details, that isn't what made me think it was a sequel to The Hook. Mm-hmm. What made me think it was a sequel to The Hook was the fan service of making the angel and the devil kiss.
I did it.
10 episodes to make it.
I did it. I said, you asked me 6 months ago, hey, you gonna write a sequel to The Hook? What's it gonna do? And what did I say? Let's play the tape.
If I came back in the second season, I was like, right, new season, resolution.
Yeah. I would probably make the angel and the devil kiss, obviously. They gotta kiss.
You gotta
make them kiss. And sure enough, I made him kiss. The last line is, because I've kissed the devil and can't be coerced. Of all God's creations, this is the worst. I did everything I promised.
Fan service. yeah, no, this is fantastic. And also, I like that we're both branching out into songs that can be played one after another, mm-hmm. you know, like the world's smallest concept albums, you know.
Yeah. I think I've made a little three set of songs that feel like a pretty self-contained little story that I might even want to flesh out a little bit more. But I think to start, I have three songs: The Hook, The Lighthouse, and The Chase. The Chase is an older song of mine that I feel like is kind of, chronologically, The Chase would be kind of the first one, because The Chase is kind of about people not being able to escape death, and I think there's obviously the hook kind of expands on like the view of like the devil kind of snatching souls off the earth, and then this is kind of chronologically the next kind of piece of that. You know, for me, The Lighthouse, I call the song The Lighthouse because The Lighthouse is the kind of thing that represents his like last little bit of like hope in like the goodness of mankind, and the fact that it's clinging to the cliff by its fingers is just a little bit of imagery. It's his like kind of like last little thing, and by the end of the song he, you know, smashes out the light.
This has been a wild season of Jam Mechanics, and we still have one episode to go. We're going to do our retrospective. You know, we're going to do our episode 11. But yeah, we have recorded episodes on the road. We have recorded episodes in people's spare rooms. We have recorded episodes weeks apart.
No such thing as a bad season of Jam Mechanics. What we're going to do on the next episode is we're not going to write any new songs, but we're going to we'll put out a little survey after this to kind of get people's thoughts on the different songs, different questions that people have about things. It's a good time for us to kind of look back and be like, okay, let's look at things that we wrote a couple months ago and kind of see what we feel differently.
Yeah, and maybe we can get that data and do the ranking thing, because that was really fun last year.
So if you're not in our Discord, now is the best time to join it. We'll put a link in the Discord description, and we'll have a pinned basically a Google form that people can fill out to kind of just let us know their thoughts on things as time has passed, and also to ask us questions that we can kind of address in the last episode.
Last year's retrospective, we put out old demos of tracks that you've probably heard. We have a couple of ideas about what we might do this year to kind of give you something a bit different, which I'm really excited about. Yeah. And yeah, okay. Thank you for sticking with us. Come back in another 2 weeks for the final episode of season two. And thank you to everybody who came out to the shows. And it was wild, especially to meet people who were like, yeah, I found you guys through Jam Mechanics. That's crazy.
Very cool. Yeah.
I was playing Get Deep Fried a lot of nights. We played a lot of The Hook. I played Piano Beacher a couple of times. And it is so, so cool that we've got people who are a fan of the show out there, so we can throw in songs and it doesn't feel like we're doing that to nobody.
It's watching people as especially as the summer went on, progressively just popping off to Artist for Amateurs night after night was so cool. It's super neat to kind of see the love whenever we'd mention Jam Mechanics at our live shows in the US this year. It was super, super fun, and we really appreciate y'all.
It has to be you. It has to be you to play us out. Who played us out last time?
It was me. I've done 9 in a row, I think. I'm pretty sure.
No. I think it was me last time. It was me last time. Because it was the doom da doom da doom da doom doom. Yeah, okay, thank God. Bug, take us home.
In front of you, there are two bugs. One must die. In front of you. There are one only tells the truth, and one only lies. Pick one wisely, 'cause one has to die. And no matter who you choose, it's always me. Hold on, let's do this. Okay. I'm gonna give that first verse, and then you do the second one.
Wait. I'm gonna bring in this chair.
I'm gonna intro this a little bit. You know what, Matt? We're in the same room. How about we both do this one? Yeah. Imagine you're going down to a basement. There's a light bulb, and there's two bugs. No, there's both of us tied up. One tells the truth, one always lies. You have to choose wisely, 'cause one of us dies.
Is that the end of the first verse?
Yeah, that's the end of the first verse.
Okay.
One tells the truth.
Me!
One always lies.
Him!
Choose wisely, 'cause one of us dies.
I tell the truth, you can see it in my eyes. He always lies, you can see it in his tooth.
Hold on. No.
We're not workshopping this.
We're workshopping it.
No.
You can see it in my eyes, you can see it in his tooth. It's pretty good.
Hold on. We're not redoing it.
Okay, fine. All right, we'll do a whole new thing then.
No!
One tells the truth, one always lies. Look at my tooth, look at his eyes.
Don't believe what this guy says, shoot him. I deserve to live. Listen to my bim bam, listen to my bim bam, listen to my bim bam, listen to my bim bam.
And then listen to Jam Mechanics.
There we go. Just a whole series of in-jokes no one's going to get.
I'm going to leave that whole thing
in
there.
Just be like, okay, take two, take three, take four.
It's going to be all.
Thank you for joining us today on Jam Mechanics.
I've cut this so long ago.
Okay. That's good. Yeah, I think that's going to be a good end.
Yeah, I have no idea.
They always told me I was peaking too early. Your lack of buddies is a little concerning. You heard the rumors, now I'm hearing confirming. I made a friend in my 30s.